Welcome, dear student from subject computational physics. Our second chapter is C programming, and from this second chapter, in this lecture we have to see variables and their declaration. Friends, we know that the constant does not change during the execution of a program, while the variables have a different value at a different instant. Okay, now while declaring variable, we should keep in mind that is a different data type. Okay, integer, floats and character and the name of a variable. The name of variable should not be keywords. So in this lecture we have to see variables and their declaration. Variable is a data name used to store data value. The variable is identifier which is used to represent some specific information in the program. It is an identifier used to represent single data item, that is either numerical value or character constant. While declaring variable, three things must keep in mind, that is its type. Okay, that is it may be integer, floats, character, its value and its address. Variable name are name given to location in a memory where different constant are stored. This location can be contain integer, real or character constant. The constant is which remain unchanged during execution of a program, while the variables can be take different value at a different time during the execution of a program. So the value of a variable is a change. It have different value at a different time during execution. If we consider one example, f is equal to 1.8 into c plus 32. Here f and c are variable, that is its value can be changed. When the value of C is a change, value of F is also change. So we have to declare these variables, okay, at the beginning of the program. Rules of a variable name. Okay, a variable name is a combination of alphabet, digit or underscore. Alphabet is also allowed. Digit is also allowed or underscore is also allowed. The first character, however, must be an alphabet. Then the no commas or blank space is allowed while constructing variable name. Then the variable name should not be keywords. Okay, variable name should not be keywords. Okay, because the keywords have a specific meaning and which is stored in a compiler. The variable can be case sensitive, that is sum, that is sum in lowercase and sum in uppercase or in a capital letter, are two distinct variable. Some valid variable names are maximum underscore length. This is variable. Why? First letter is alphabet, underscore is allowed. Then second example is age. Age is a variable name. X, Y, Z, this is also variable name. V, A, G, A, V, G, average. Okay, this is also variable name, valid variable name. A1 is a valid variable name because numbers are also allowed. Okay, so A1 is a valid variable name. T1 is also valid variable name. Okay, so these are some rules. Okay, while constructing the variable name. Okay, that is a variable name is a combination of alphabet, digit, underscore. This is the first rule. Second rule, first character, however, must be alphabet. No comma, blank space are allowed while constructing variable. Variable name should not be keyword, and the variables are case sensitive. If we consider, we declare a variable name sum, sum in lowercase, but if we use sum in uppercase, okay, in any logical or arithmetic operation, then there is an error. That is, variables are undeclared, or it is a not declared. Okay, so variables are case sensitive. Now, this rule remain same for all types of primary and secondary variables. Naturally, the question follows, how C is able to differentiate between these variables? This is a rather simple matter. C compiler is able to distinguish between the variable names by making compulsory for you to declare the type of any variable name that you wish to use in the program. So we have to declare the variable at the beginning of a program by using different data type. Okay, the type declaration is done at the beginning of the program. Following are the examples of type declare statement. Syntax for declaring variable is as follows: data type. Okay, we can use a different data type, that is integer, floats, or character. V1, V2, V3, up to so on Vn, where V1, V2, V3 are name of the variables and the data type. We can use a data type. Okay, this is declaration of a variable. To declare the variable, we required data type and variable name. Okay, now type of a C variable, primary type declaration. Okay, in that we can use integer variable, can hold only an integer constant. If you consider integer a, b, c, here integer int is a data type. Okay, a, b, c are declared as an integer variable. A, b, c is actually variable. Okay, the integer variable can be declared as a short integer, or we can use a short integer, long integer, sign integer, sign short integer, and sign long integer. Okay, integer is data type. Okay, so if it is a data type, it may be short, it may be long, it may be signed, it may be unsigned, it may be signed short integer, it may be signed long integer. A, B, C are the variable name. Now, real variable can hold only real constant, that is, which consists of a floating point, or we can say that this number consists of a decimal point. Floats root 1, root 2. Okay, root 1 and root 2 are floating point variable, that is, it consists of decimal point. Okay, so this is a real variable which is a use to hold only a real constant. Then character variable can hold only character constant, character flags. Okay, character type flag variable, it may be signed character, it may be unsigned character. Okay, character is data type, and we can use or we can declare a different character from the 26 character. We can declare any one character as a variable. Okay, so these are the primary type declaration, which consist of integer variable. Integer variable can hold only an integer constant. Real variable hold only a real constant, and character variable can be hold only character constant. Then defining constant. In a C, the value can be assigned to a variable name. If no variable is assigned, it is undefined. If variable is not declared at the beginning of the program, then it is undefined. The error is undefined or undeclared. Example, integer a is equal to 2. A is equal to 2. 2 is a integer. So we use int, integer. This is a data type. A is equal to 2. T is equal to minus 3842. Value, it is equal to 1234, and float y, it is z is equal to 2.5678 e raised to minus 5 or 10 raised to minus 5. Q is equal to minus 3.1234 e raised to 7 or 10 raised to 7. So these are the floating point. So while considering a variable, the data type is very important. Data type and variable name, these two are very important. Data type, integer, floats, character, and variable name have different rules. If variable are undefined, it cannot be used in arithmetic and logical operation.